So Loki has begun filming outside. Oh boy, you know what that means. Set leaks. And sure enough, these pictures have just been snapped. Huge shout out to BTT viewer Guy Tomlinson. He was very nice. He said, can I get a shout out? He was the first to alert me. I think he was the first. He sent me a direct message. That's how we had this interaction, these photos had gone up. And I always, you know, I'm on top of this stuff, but I really appreciate it when you guys send it to me. It helps me be even faster, and it also makes me feel nice because I know that means you're looking forward to discussing it with me. And that's exactly what we're going to do right now. So thanks again, Guy. So lo and behold, Loki has gone from TVA prisoner to agent rather quickly. Of course he does. Loki's very good at ingratiating himself, right? Look what he did as soon as he landed on Sakaar. It's like one of his superpowers, or just plain powers, because he's an Asgardian god. Although not all the Asgardians have powers, interestingly enough. Loki doesn't even, they never really established that in the MCU. All right, so, well, he can, like, transform and stuff like that. You know, he's weird. Loki was, like, the first villain, but then he almost immediately became an anti-hero, and he's never been particularly heroic, never particularly much of a villain. So I'm looking forward to this series finally really defining him. I think that would be great. He said some rather mean things to Black Widow in the first Avengers movie, quite frankly, a little bit sexist, but that was before the Me Too movement. You better hope nobody brings that up. All right, so anyway. TVA, of course, stands for, as we discussed when they first dropped the trailer for the Disney Plus shows, the Marvel Disney Plus shows, it stands for Time Variance Authority, which debuted in the Thor comics, appropriately. So they should debut in the MCU in a Thor-based storyline. But you know what this means? This means that this Disney Plus show is going to seriously encroach on Netflix's Umbrella Academy. And I think perhaps it's one of the most aggressive moves from Disney against Netflix yet. I mean, it's even, not only does it have time travel, but it has investigating time travel in a procedural way, and also an organization that does so in a very bureaucratic way. The TVA has faceless people who work for it, although everybody here has a face. That would have been cool if they had done that with the SWAT team that we see here, but they're not doing that. That'd be cool. That would be cool. But perhaps a little bit more expensive than Disney Plus wishes. They're like, we have other stuff to spend our money on. Did you not hear that we are a time travel show? Although this looks pretty well contained as a budget with this shoot right here, this scene. So yes, very much like Umbrella Academy, even down to number 5, who looks a lot like Kid Loki. He could play Kid Loki, in fact. And I'm sure Disney's like, yes, come over here. All right, that's what they want everyone to do. And for as far as the MCU goes, mixing comic books with another genre has become a very successful part of the overall MCU formula. They don't do it for every movie, but they do it. And it started with Winter Soldier, and that was very effective. So to make Loki a procedural show, but one about time travel, I think would work perfectly with that formula, and I think it's quite exciting. It's surprising. I wouldn't expect this with this character. We'll discuss that. But it's good, but it's also very similar to Umbrella Academy. I wonder when their season 2 drops, they should take a hard look at that Loki is expected to drop and try and make sure they beat it to streaming. So here we have pics of Loki, including some in the rain. You're welcome, Loki stands. And then also, as I pointed out, a TVA version of a SWAT unit. We also have a female character on set, played by Sophia DiMartino, who we'll discuss in just a moment. But even more exciting is that I believe that's Mr. Owen Wilson. It's a little hard to tell, but I think the distinct nose. I think that's Owen Wilson. It looks like Owen Wilson. And I was like, is he really that much shorter than Tom Hiddleston? And I looked it up, and he is. So that very much indeed, I think, could be and is Owen Wilson. Now, it looks here like he's maybe playing Loki's superior. He could be Mr. Alternity, who runs the TVA in the comics, or maybe someone a little lower down, but who's still higher up than Loki in the hierarchy, right, at the TVA. As I said, very bureaucratic. But then, I like this more. I like something else even more, which we'll get to. But he could be Loki. This is how we get there. So he could be Loki's more experienced partner. It is listed on IMDb that he will appear in all 6 episodes. He's not someone who just shows up for 1 or 2 of them. And in procedurals, of course, law enforcement comes in pairs. There's all that partner banter. And I think Owen Wilson would be obviously great at that. I mean, Tom Hiddleston couldn't ask for a better scene partner. With Loki, so maybe Owen Wilson could be Mr. Paradox, who's another famous member of the TVA in the comics. Famous is very loose because no one really has heard of the TVA, certainly not modern comic book readers, but Mr. Paradox is the character who's established there. And then Mr. Paradox would be Owen Wilson, while Loki could be the MCU's version of Mr. Tesseract, as some people have already pointed out, because of course he used the Tesseract to escape the timeline in Avengers Endgame. Wilson also, though, could be Justice Peace, perhaps the most famous TVA member in the comics overall. Then on that note, I want to address the female character played by Sophia DiMartino. Some of you said maybe she's Lady Loki because her costume does look a little bit like his costume in the movies. But I think she could also, it does look a lot like that, but she could also maybe just be Asgardian. Maybe she stole it. I mean, she's blonde here, and she doesn't look like she's about to put a wig on. She'd have to have a wig cap for that. And I think the whole point of Lady Loki is that it's supposed to be very much him as a woman, where that doesn't seem to be, that would be poor casting if she was playing Lady Loki, in my opinion. She could be playing, though, some of you also said, Enchantress. She's another she's an enchantress. She has superpowers, just like Loki. She's I'd say a B-level villain for Thor. It's funny, they all wear green in the comics. Green, like in Hela too. Green is like the black of Asgard, apparently, right? That's what the super cool, tortured people wear. I guess I like to wear black, so if I lived in Asgard, I guess I'd be wearing green. I'm not seeing it, I like black. But anyway, it's a very dark green. It's almost black. It's like that funny thing, if you've ever seen Dudley Do-Right, side note, they have a fantastic gag about black versus navy and how they're often mistaken for each other. It's the best, it's the only reason to see the movie, quite frankly. So maybe they could do something funny here as well. So I think since she's blonde and I think she's wearing green and she seems to have a costume that looks Asgardian, probably Enchantress. I don't know why she'd be in a time travel story, to be honest with you, but we'll see. I also feel this is like, with all due respect to Sophia DiMartino, kind of underwhelming casting for like a pretty, well, she's not a big character, but she's pretty popular. She has fans. So to introduce her in a streaming show with an actress who's not that big a deal, I mean, but maybe she's the new Jodie Comer. We'll see. Although good luck trying to be as good as Jodie Comer. Although maybe she can do it. But the reason I wanted to bring her up now is that there's also a female Justice character for the TVA, Justice Love from the comic, so maybe there's some chance that's who she's playing. But again, with the green, she's not dressed like any of the other TVA agents, including Loki here. It seems Asgardian, so again, I think it's Enchantress. Now back to Owen Wilson. This is my favorite theory. If he's the partner of Loki's character here in the TVA, wouldn't it be great if he eventually became Kang? What if Kang in the MCU started out working for the TVA, but then decides to go rogue? Loki feels he's the villain with his own alternative agenda, but little does he know his partner is thinking even bigger. Oh, I would just love that so much. And Kang, of course, is Marvel's famous time-traveling villain. Again, I use the term famous loosely, because most people wouldn't know who Kang is. But if you do, that's who he is. I think that would be fantastic. It would be a lot like Umbrella Academy. You know, he knows the system from the inside and he uses that to his advantage to exploit it. But that's par for the course when it comes to procedurals, and I think that could be really, really interesting. And also, Kang is a character worthy of someone of Owen Wilson's stature as a movie star. Maybe not so much today, but I think Owen Wilson certainly, he deserves to play a really cool character. And from here on out, he'd be able to jump in and out of any MCU movie, even the prequels, because it's time travel, going forward. But he could do that even if he was just a regular TVA agent who stayed a good guy. I mean, Owen Wilson, any member of the TVA can forever pop up in cameos for the rest of the time in the MCU, which is really cool. And they can even do some cool extra scenes where they could digitally insert them in older films from the MCU. There's a lot of fun stuff to play with here. And that alone could appeal to Owen Wilson. But it would be great, I think, if he were Kang, if this was like Kang's origin story. Oh, that would be great. And as I've mentioned before, Owen Wilson is great casting because he has the same vibe as Taika Waititi and also Jeff Goldblum, who Taika Waititi also brought into the MCU, and Thor Ragnarok. And casting choices like this, I think, would cement what Taika Waititi started, and that's making the Thor corner of the MCU wonderfully zany. And I think in a little bit of a different way than what James Gunn has brought to Guardians of the Galaxy. But there's a crossover there, which is why, of course, Thor spends some time with the Guardians of the Galaxy. So what do you think of these set picks? Do you agree it's a bit of a curveball and an odd choice for Loki? I think it only is really justifiable if it does put Kang on the board. But, you know, I trust the MCU at this point, so I'm just curious to see what they are doing. Part of me thinks maybe that Loki's in disguise, you know, that we see Loki and everyone else sees someone else, but of course, in the MCU, he genuinely transforms, or at least has in the past. But I definitely think he has his own agenda, as he always does. The question is, what's Owen Wilson's? And then also, I don't know, with this kind of storyline as a procedural, how would Lady Loki or Kid Loki show up, which is the rumor. Maybe Enchantress is the factor that puts that into play, so that would make her inclusion a good thing, make it make sense. So I'm very curious, but I think the show is off to a very interesting start, and we get to see all the main cast members right away, so that's very cool. They're walking around outside, just like the Suicide Squad people were in their set photos. All right, I guess that's what you do when you shoot a movie. Your characters walk around outside. All right, so anyway, you know what I mean. All right, share your thoughts down below, subscribe today, and of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.